Do you feel like you're not really getting anywhere in games? Reached a point where you feel like this is it? In this video, we're gonna talk about this. However, we're not gonna make it negative. We're gonna make it positive. And teach you how you can change any situation in your favor. When you play a competitive game, do you play for hours and hours and then go to bed and the next day repeat? Do you often find yourself blaming your teammates for mistakes that could have been your own? And do you find yourself being the just one more game kind of person? Now, if you want, you can pause the video or listen to the questions again. If you answered already, feel free to continue. Now, the first thing I'm going to touch on is when I was playing at my peak in Overwatch, I reached 4453 SR to be exact. For those that doesn't play Overwatch, that rank at the current time was top 300 in Europe. Now, how did I reach that rank? I don't have much more playtime than your average person. I even had less playtime than most people in my rank. So how did I, with minimal playtime, reach my peak performance? Before we go deep into this, I want to talk about the human brain. Now, I want you to imagine that you jump into a time machine and you end up far in the past and appear in front of a few cavemen. Now, one of the first things people will think about, unless they freak out of course, is that, wow, I'm in the past. Another thing would probably come to your mind, and that is that you are much smarter than these past humans. However, what's interesting here is that our technology has evolved much faster than what our brain has. So to be exact, these cavemen have the exact same brain as you do. But I am still smarter, right? You are smarter in terms of technology. However, if you would introduce and teach these cavemen how to use a phone, they would probably be able to. If you would be able to get past the language barrier, that is. However, these cavemen are probably faster, stronger, and know much more about the land and survival, which makes them smarter than you in that term. And of course, now you might wonder, TossarN, this is a video about how I can improve in video games. Why are you teaching me about the human brain? So here is the twist. Technology has advanced faster than what we have. So speaking, your body's still made for moving around. It's made to physically be active. If you search, there have been many tests surrounding the brain, and people that exercise a lot actually makes the brain de-age, or become younger in a way. By using your body, it makes your brain healthier and also refreshed. Now I will make a connection to video games again. By refreshing your brain, you will also perform better. And this goes for any sport. However, as esport isn't physically active, you need to move and exercise instead of rest to make it work better when gaming. And this mentality goes for all those questions above. If you just sit down and play and play and play, you're gonna wear yourself out. You're gonna become much more aggressive and not think as much before you act. When you're tired and you've lost a lot and you think just one more game, you further strain your mental health, which will probably make you lose that just one more game. And remember, I had less playtime than average when I was at my peak. I took breaks, I helped my body out, took a walk, went to the gym, ate healthy. With healthy, I don't just mean, you know, eat your greens. I mean any kind of food that isn't junk food. Now, if you don't want to exercise hard, there's no need to. But you still need to give your brain the break it deserves. You control your brain, which controls your body. However, your brain is so complex that it also controls you. Now, as said, you are the master, but you are also your worst enemy. After watching this video, I want you to try this out. When you are done with your session, be it short or be it longer, take a break for an hour or two. Do something that doesn't revolve around technology. Put your phone down and just take in the environment. Get a sip of fresh air, and then when you are done, get back and try again. I can almost guarantee you that you are going to feel like you are performing better than before. A tired brain will not learn. It will repeat the mistakes it did a few hours ago. A refreshed brain is eager to improve and drive you forward. Now, this was a short session, and I'll gladly answer any of your questions that you wish to give me in the comments below. Now remember guys, be awesome, stay great, and as always, I'll see you next time.